All right, everybody, welcome back. And I just want to shoot this video real quick, let you guys know a little bit more about Bitcoin. Okay, so one of the flaws in the Bitcoin network, or one of the things to exploit in the Bitcoin network, is the small block size. All right, and the block size is the amount of transactions that can fit into a block at any given period. Okay, so with that being said, if I wanted to kind of, you know, show off on the Bitcoin network and prove that it was, you know, not so good of a network and couldn't handle, you know, the pressure that, you know, a monetary system could possibly put on it, then what I could do is I could exploit, again, the block size and how it would affect the masses. All right. This will not only slow down transaction time, but it would also increase transaction costs. All right. So a lot of people have probably already noticed when they're trying to send a Bitcoin transaction, the cost is extremely high. All right. It shouldn't be that high in order for you to send your money, especially when the other alternative networks that are out there that you can, you know, do the same thing. You can transact value peer to peer with no central government or no central authority involved, then you can do that with alternative networks other than Bitcoin. All right, so again, check this out. So if I wanted to do that, if I wanted to exploit that block size, what I would do is I would just start to flood the network with transactions. I can flood the network with a lot of puny transactions, and what is that going to give me? After a while, it's going to give me what you call unconfirmed transactions. All right, and in the blockchain, we know that in order to secure the network and validate the transactions, we have to use what we call the miners. All right, and the miners, they use supercomputers all day to solve mathematical algorithms to, you know, solve these blocks or discover these blocks or make sure that these blocks and every transaction inside this block is a valid transaction. Okay, so that's the process of confirming a transaction. We all know now that it takes up to 6 confirmations for a Bitcoin transaction to be deemed valid and a spendable transaction. Okay, so right now, we're experiencing extremely long confirmation times. All right, as a matter of fact, we usually see confirmations happen within 10 to 20 minutes or so. All right. Right now, I've had people call me already, and they've had unconfirmed transactions for over a day now. Again, this does exploit the Bitcoin network and start to have you wander off into other markets. All right, other alternative ways to transact value. Okay, we all know that the Ethereum network transacts a lot faster. All right, the Litecoin network transfers a lot faster. The Dash network transfers a lot faster, privately and anonymously. Okay, but again, these are things that will exploit the Bitcoin network and will make it inferior to other alternative markets that are out there. Okay, so again, we got over 116,000 unconfirmed transactions right now. So if you're having a problem with getting a transaction verified or seeing a transaction pop up to its recipient, then hey, blame it all on the blockchain. But do not worry, all right? Everything that happens on the blockchain is at public disclosure. So hey, you can go and witness everything that happens on the blockchain. All right, the blockchain is a public distributed ledger where all of the Bitcoin transactions are publicly recorded. Okay, so thanks again for checking this out. I really appreciate you guys watching, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.